Welcome to Pastor's Chat. I am so excited to study the book of Colossians with you. I really felt the Lord leading me to use this as our next study on Pastor's Chat. This is such an exciting book, an encouraging book, a helpful book, a practical book, also a very deep book in the sense that we find that Jesus Christ is supreme. He is preeminent over all things. You know, I believe one of the great problems in the church today is that so many of us give Christ a place of eminence. Yes, we make a big deal about who He is, but we forget that He's preeminent. He is the first of all. He is head of all. And that's what the book of Colossians reminds us about. And in every area of our life, Jesus Christ should be preeminent. He should be preeminent. We should not have a thought in a sense. We should not have an action or a deed. We should not have any type of area of our life that's not under the lordship of Jesus Christ, because we know He is preeminent. We so easily live for the things that are temporal and forget the things that are eternal. That's why we're using as our text verse for the chapter and for the whole study, Colossians chapter 3. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Immediately we're reminded, as Paul gets into the doctrinal section of this book, that Jesus is right now at the right hand of God. There He ever lives to make intercession for us, we find in the book of Hebrews. He is Lord of all already. He is conqueror. He is deliverer. He is victorious over Satan, hell, death, the grave. He is preeminent. And we, in this book, will see that over and over again. And He wants to be preeminent in every area of our lives. So therefore, we seek those things that are above. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things on the earth. For you have died. Okay, why? Romans 6. When Christ died, you died. When He was buried, you were buried. When He raised from the dead the third day, you rose with Him. That's the truth of the Scripture. That's the fact of the spiritual life. It's a reality. I'm telling you, if we can begin to understand, Christ is preeminent. Christ is real. Christ is truth. He is everything. That's why Colossians 2 says, in Him are hidden all the treasures of truth and knowledge. In Him are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. And then in chapter 1, Paul talked twice about the truth of the gospel. When you heard the word of truth, the truth of the gospel, the word of truth. Why? Jesus says, I'm the way, the truth. Now, He's not a truth among truths. He is the truth. He is the living reality. And when we know Him and have a relationship with Him, oh, my friend, everything changes. Now, I preached a message yesterday morning at Rainbow Sunday on May the 2nd, today's May 3rd, I preached a message on, it's not about you. It's not about you. I'm telling you today, especially in America, we got it all backward. We think it's about us. Everything's about us. It's about my pleasure, about my happiness, about my joy, about my money, about my life, about my job, about my vocation, about my children, about my church, about my. But my friend, when you read the book of Colossians, you're going to find out it's not about you. It's about Jesus Christ. And that's what he goes on to say. You have died. Your life is hidden with Christ in God. If I had a couple titles for this series, one I would call it The Hidden Life. That's one of them. The Hidden Life. Hidden. Something that's hidden you don't see. And then the next verse, when Christ, who is your life, appears, then you'll also appear here with Him in glory. When Christ, who is your life? When Christ, who is your life? Christ, who is your life? Would be my other title. Is Christ your life today? Is that who you live for? Is that who you're looking forward to seeing one day? Oh, my friend, that's what my prayer is, that you will live the hidden life. People don't see you because you're hidden in Christ with God, and they see God. Because I love that verse in Matthew 6. Jesus says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. How do you know that it's your good works they're seeing and not you? Because if they're seeing you and you're making a big deal about what you're doing, they glorify you. Oh, they recognize you. But when they see your good works, they glorify your Father in heaven. Oh, may God help us to understand these truths as we apply them to our lives. God bless and have a wonderful day.